अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन, कैसे हैं आप सभी? बस होप सो आप सब लोग ठीक होंगे। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक द एलिजबेथन थिएटर एंड व्हाट वाज द सेलिएंट फीचर्स ऑफ द एलिजबेथन थिएटर। आज की जो हमारी डिस्कशन का टॉपिक है वो है अबाउट एलिजबेथन थिएटर, व्हाट वाज द एलिजबेथन थिएटर एंड व्हाट वाज द सेलिएंट फीचर ऑफ द थिएटर। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द वीडियो आप लोगों से कहना चाहूँगी कि अगर स्टिल यू पीपल हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल, प्लीज़ डू सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल एंड प्रेस द बटन ऑफ बेल आइकॉन सो मे यू विल रिसीव द नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ माई कमिंग वीडियोज़। थैंक यू वेरी मच। ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट द टॉपिक विच इज़ अबाउट द एलिजबेथन थिएटर। So basically, first of all, we will see that the theatres were of two distinct kinds. There are two kinds of the theatre. Number one is that public theatres and number two was private theatres. The government closely regulated the both, but particularly the public theatres. In the start, they are saying that there are basically two major types of the theatres. One of them is public theatres and number two is the private theatres. Public theatres are that which was made for the public use only, which were publicly launched, publicly used. Used and the publicly set, and then number two, the private theatres, which was mostly regulated by the royal people or the most aristocrat people of that society. Actually, both of the theatres were mainly regulated by the government, but particularly only the public theatres were more closely regulated by the government, and the private theatres were more regulated by the aristocratic class. Shakespeare made his livelihood with fairly large open air structures able to hold about 5,000 people. Actually, this time was of the Shakespeare also. This is the time when Shakespeare wrote his work, and this is that Shakespeare was the person who was able to hold the attention of 5,000 people, because attending theaters at that time was very usually uncommon. Us time pe jo hai wo theaters attend karna, jana aana, ya theaters launch करना वेरी अनकॉमन था, अनयूजुअल था। बट शेक्सपियर का जो वर्क है, उसके जो सब्जेक्ट मैटर आए, दे वर वेरी हाईली क्वालिफाइड, एंड शेक्सपियर मेड हिज लिवलीहुड एंड दैट्स व्हाई ही वाज एबल टू होल्ड द अटेंशन ऑफ 5,000 पीपल एट दैट टाइम। Before attending the theatres, the rival theatres were more popular, and there were two kinds of rival theatres, bull baiting and the bear baiting. Actually, these are the kinds of some festivals which were launched before the theatres launching. मतलब theatres launching से पहले जो है वो इस किस्म के जो है rival theatres जो हैं वो ज़्यादा launch किए जाते थे। Bull baiting, bear baiting. Bull baiting is a kind of festival in which they share or something. There is a race of the bulls, and the bear baiting in which also there is a race or the competition between the beer. So this was differently launched, and different publicly people participate and compete with each other. As I earlier told you that this was the time of the Shakespeare. Shakespeare wrote his work during this time. So attending theaters become common. People used to stay, used to go theaters, and then there comes the time when 2,000 plays were written by 250 dramatists between 1590 to 1642. कहते हैं फिर जो है वो थिएटर्स अटेंड करना, आना जाना, लॉन्च करना जो है ये बहुत ज़्यादा कॉमन हो गया। लोग जो है आने जाने लगे, पीपल डिवेल्प देअर इंटरेस्ट, लोगों का इंटरेस्ट डिवेल्प हो गया, एंड देन एट दिस टाइम ऑलमोस्ट इन 52 ईयर्स डिफरेंट ड्रामेटिक्स 250 ड्रामेटिक्स रोट ऑलमोस्ट 2,000 प्लेज। Because of the weather, plague, Puritan opposition and religious observance, theatres often advertised on a day-to-day basis, unlike today when we know in advance the dates a show will run. One of the most memorable advertising techniques drops employed involving running by a specific flag atop the theatres to signal a performance that day. Then they are saying that the performances were made on the day-to-day basis performances were made, and due to the some religious observances these were made. One of the most important advertising technique was using as that when it was a day, they will at the top of the theater they will hang a particular kind of the flag, a particular color kind of particular colors flag they will atop at the theater. वो जो है पर्टिकुलर काइंड का कलर का जो है वो अकॉर्डिंग टू परफॉर्मेंस जो है वो थिएटर की टॉप पे जो है वो एक पर्टिकुलर कलर का जो है वो फ्लैग एडवर्टाइज कर देते थे। This was some category. The category was that the black flag when there is performance of a tragedy, a red flag when there is a performance going for history, and a white flag for the comedy. All action took place in front of a general three tiered facade. Public theaters varied in shape, circular, octagonal, square, yet their purpose was the same, to surround a playing area in such a way as to accommodate a large number of the paying spectators. Actually, the venue, if I going to talk about the venue, that how was the venue of the theaters, means what was the setting of the, then the public theaters were basically of three kinds. They were circular in shape, they were octagonal, and they were square in shape, but their main purpose was only one, that to surround a playing area, means they are going to surround a particular area in which the spectators will easily watch the drama or anything which is going to perform on the stage. Each theater was also made up of three distinct seating areas. Then they are saying that according to seating arrangement, they made a distinction between the seating areas, mean they categorize, as in society we have made classes at upper, middle, and lower. So it's a case with the same, the theaters, that they made the three seating distinct areas for the people. The pit, number one, there was the pit, standing room only, primarily for the lower classes. The pit was made for whom? There is a standing room for the only lower class who will stand there and watch the drama. Number two, there was the public gallery, bench seats for the middle classes. There was made some benches for the public, which is made for the middle class people. In the box seats, which is specially designed appropriate for the Puritans aristocracy. So this was a seating arrangement in the theaters according to the classes. Then there was a pit, the public gallery, and the box seats according to their social status, for the lower class and for the middle and for the higher upper aristocrat class respectively. The private theaters of the Shakespeare's day offered a definite alternative to the more public playhouses. These venues were open to the public, but special consideration made it unusual for common to attend. First, the private playhouses accommodate only about 300 spectators. In addition, they provided actual seats for the patrons, helping to justify a considerably higher admission than the public theaters. Now, they are saying that at the time of Shakespeare, because there was, I earlier told you that it was very uncommon to attend the theaters at that time. It was very uncommon, unusual at that time. But Shakespeare made the change, and the theaters were, people developed some interest, and they start to go to the theaters. When the private theaters were established, they were only the place for only 300 spectators. But Shakespeare made the change, and he took the theaters publicly, and he launched the theaters publicly in order to dramatize the drama for the audience, for a large audience. Unlike the open theaters, private theaters were roofed and lit by the candles, allowing for the evening performances, a time when most commoners needed to be doing chores around their own homes. During performances too, the private theaters would often separate the acts with musical interludes rather than performing the entire play without any intermission, as they did in the public theater. Now they are drawing the comparison between the public theaters and the private theaters. They told that the public theaters were mainly roofless, there was no kind of any roof, and they were only publicly launched, and in the open air they were mainly launched, while the private theaters were roofed, and also they were fascinated by the candles, and also there was the performances which are going to act, they were at the evening time, means people get free from their works and they come easily and watch the drama. And during the performances, the private theaters, in private theaters they also introduces the use of the musical instruments, while in public theaters there was nothing use of the musical instruments. So this was the difference in public and theaters and the private theaters. So we have discussed that what was the Elizabethan theater, what were the types of the theater, and what are the main salient features of the theater. I hope so you people have made it clear from this topic, and if then you people feeling any sort of query, you can ask. And thank you very much. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and like my videos. Thank you very much.